Hey everyone! Today is an exciting day because I have just received a brand new Creality Falcon 2 laser cutter equipped with a powerful 22 watt laser. Let's dive into the unboxing and setup process. I was pleasantly surprised. Unlike many other laser cutters that require you to reassemble the frame and other parts, the Falcon 2 comes mostly pre-assembled, making it super convenient. Right out of the box, I noticed that the main laser module carriage is not aligned properly with the frame. I quickly measured and there was a 13 mm difference. I held one end and pushed the other to make it even, and at the end I got it fairly square. Now it looks much better. Otherwise it feels heavy and solid in hand. Here is what I had to do to finish setting it up. Four rubber feet simply screw into the corners of the base. The laser module slides right into the place with a couple of set screws to secure it. The air assist hose is easy to connect. One end goes to the laser module and the other to the air assist unit, which helps keep the lens clean and improves cutting performance. Then I connect a power input or air assist pump, and here you can manually adjust the airflow. And the last thing was to connect power cable from laser module. The Creality Falcon 2 is powered by a 22 watt laser, a step up from the more common 20 watt lasers that many competitors offer. One of the standout features of the Falcon 2 is its integrated air assist system. Unlike other lasers where you need to manually add an air assist module, this one comes built in and can be controlled directly from a software for a much smoother workflow. I will show you that in a minute. Besides controlling directly from the software, you can do that manually as well. Thanks to the extra power from the 22 watt laser, the Falcon 2 offers faster cutting and engraving speeds compared to the lower powered models. This speed boost can be a huge time saver, especially when working on larger projects or cutting through thicker materials. Falcon 2 is equipped with a lot of safety features, comes with triple monitoring system, which keeps an eye on air pressure to ensure proper air assist function during the engraving or cutting, fire hazards, automatically shuts down if the fire is detected and moves away, lens health to prevent damage to the lens. The system is designed to give you a peace of mind while you work. At the front of the machine, you will find a dial for adjusting the air assist speed that I mentioned earlier. Falcon 2 doesn't have an onboard display, but it does have a microSD card slot that lets you load your files directly onto the machine. There is also an emergency stop button for quick shutdowns if something goes wrong. It's really easy to press and release. For an extra security, you can lock the machine with a key, so unauthorized users can't turn it on. I received this USB stick with the machine and it should be loaded all files necessary to start with the machine, but for some reason this one didn't work properly. So I went online on Creality website and downloaded necessary test files. The Creality Falcon 2 doesn't come with software, but it is compatible with Lightburn, a powerful and widely used laser engraving program. Here is how I set it up. First, I opened Lightburn and I went to the Devices tab to add the machine. I connected Falcon 2 with my PC via USB cable. This way, automatically a Lightburn detected and I was able to finish setting that up. At the moment, I am using trial version Lightburn. Then I disconnected the machine and inserted the micro SD card. And saved a test file, including material test. I began by running a material test file. These tests are super helpful to dial in the best speed and power setting for different materials. I left wooden plate directly on aluminium plate, which is not a great way to do it, and that is why it's a little bit sticky and burned. For the next test, I lifted up the wooden plate and ran a test file that was downloaded from Creality. It looks amazing first engraving and cutting. The edges are crisp and they are not burned. This is a really pleasant result. I'm running the same file here, but without air this time. You can see a blinking red light on control panel. I'm doing the comparison to see importance and efficiency with the air assist system. On the left side here is with air, on the right hand side it's without air. There is a clear difference, and air assist system is really beneficial to be on. The next material that I used was cardboard. I was curious to see how it performs for cardboard, and I was carried away. I did three of them. It looks amazing. Now I'm cutting a hard wood, oak. It's really dense wood and heavy. It's cutted all the way through, just a teeny tiny bit isn't cutted in the bottom. But still, it's impressive result. Very clean edges. I also had to try with leather. I use the leather quite often in my videos. Then I cut the second one with a slower speed and I got a superb result. While I was working and switching cards from PC and machine, I came up with the idea to use a small folder and print out small labels with a graphic on it. It's easy to see which file I'm inserting in the machine. It's a great way if you work on some projects often. You don't need to transfer it all the time to the card, but this way it's always available. Bigger cardboard just to make a small frame. Again, it looks really good and it's cutted pretty fast. I also was curious how it's gonna engrave on brass. I prepared the surface of brass, cleaned and painted in black, and then I run file for Miller's Falls logo. This engraving took around 7 minutes. I run also the same file on leather to see how it's gonna look. This was also with great result. And lastly, on the wood. No exceptions here, really good result. After seeing performance of the Creality Falcon 2 22-watt laser, I think it's an excellent choice for those who need a versatile, powerful and safe laser cutter. It's ideal for both hobbyists looking to create custom items and small business owners needing a reliable tool for production. I included promotional links in the video description below. I highly recommend buying Honeycomb as well. It's a great addition to this powerful machine.